Illuminati confirmed. Alright, we'll be back with Bernard Bernoulli and Dr. Fred.
I got the contract for you to sign, Doctor.
Sorry, I don't like to sign things that I haven't read.
Okay, so read it first.
I'm busy trying to think of a way to save humanity. I don't have time to read. Now leave me alone.
Okay. What happens if I just pull this lever?
There, it's off. But it's too late now.
Where do we leave off in the thing? Give me a couple things to start out on.
So, we do need to start with Hoagie, because we need to get the soap.
He has the soap, I think. Oh, no, that's right. I couldn't get the soap. We couldn't get the soap because the maid is, like, freaking, like, cat-like reflexes.
Yes.
So, you try to get the soap, and the maid just, like, craps all over your plans. So, let's try to get the soap. Let me get my water here. Got me a bubbly. Some bubbly water. I love the music too. Alright, so how do we get the soap?
So we need to go up to the room. George Washington's room.
Wait. Is it using? Don't tell me what it is, but give me a hint. So George Washington's room. She always. There must. Is it? Does it have to do with something that I have? Levon says, Haru, Pinky.
Wait, do you have a bucket?
I do have a bucket.
Just check. You don't need to.
This is really weird. Okay.
You need to use something in the room before you call her.
Like, the only thing is to use the bed.
Here I am. Don't get your curls in an uproar. Excuse me, Mr. Washington. Boy, what a mess.
So now I can get the soap?
Now she's adequately distracted so she can get the soap.
Oh, man. Can't believe I missed that the first time.
Sorry.
Pinky is great, Levon. She didn't answer, but she's super great.
Oh, yes. Sorry, Levon. I'm doing well. I had a great stream today what's it called? Wind Waker.
And by great, she means she got so frustrated she had to take a break.
I really had to take a break. I got really frustrated at one point.
It was tough.
I was just missing all the clues, so
that's okay.
What happens.
All right, so from here, I've got the soap. What am I doing with these chattering teeth? Am I giving these to... Oh, I'm giving these to the horse, aren't I?
That was something they did very early in here, and then we did a bunch of other stuff.
Well, that's a stupid thing to do with a perfectly good set of chattering teeth.
Okay, so now you want to go outside, and you're going to use the soap and bucket.
Oh, I need to fill it with water first, though, don't I? But I know where to do that. Are we making it rain? Is that what we're trying to do? I vaguely remember this from the game. So, if I recall, you fill the bucket with water by using it with a pump. Okay. And then we're gonna go outside. And we're gonna wash the carriage? Okay. And so the joke here is, if I recall this correctly, you know what? No, I'm not going to spoil it.
The water's all sudsy now. Dum-de-dum.
Yeah, the joke is every time you wash your car, it starts to rain.
Looks like a big storm. See, this is why I never wash my car. Hey, Ben.
Oh, it's you.
Where are you going? What about your experiment?
Even science sometimes gets cold on account of rain, my boy.
But how are you ever going to get lightning if you're not going to stand out in a storm?
To be frank, which I am, I don't know. The science of electrodynamics, much like your mind apparently, is still in a state of relative infancy. Back to the drawing board, I say.
What a genius.
Whatever, man. Okay, so now it starts. Thanks, movies. Okay, so now I've got a bucket full of soapy water, a lab coat. Chattering teeth, a right-handed hammer, oil. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that. I guess I should go up and talk to Ben now that he's in his room, right?
Hi.
Sorry, can't talk. Busy making history.
Kizu. Why you growly? Oh, a wink too. Alright, I don't know what's next. I'm locked. I'm
okay,
stuck.
Okay, so this says that after you do the thing, then there will be a letter.
There's a letter from me? In the mailbox?
Shiba, come here! Come here!
Do we have Plants vs. Zombies Garden Wars 2? No, we do not.
We do not.
We have the original Plants vs. Zombies.
I have Plants vs. Zombies 2 on mobile, but not on 4. Come here. Up, up,
up. Oh, there is a letter.
Up, 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 up.
You're brilliant. What a novel design. Come to Baltimore at once.
Oh, you're brilliant. What a...
And you want to send that letter...
I feel like that's gonna be Laverne.
Nope.
Bernard?
Yeah.
Okay.
And Bernard is gonna have a lot of things to do. Yes, good girl. You're in a good spot now.
Okay, Bernard, we go. It's pretty fun.
Now. There is someone who would really like to hear that they have some food.
Hi, Vanelskra. We are... Vanelskra,
hey!
Here's how it works. I'm playing the game.
Yes.
But when I get stuck, because we have to end at 10 o'clock tonight, when I get stuck, I say, I'm stuck, and Pinky helps me out.
Yes. So I am the... I'm just the hint giver.
So now, the Baltimore thing, do I just give this to... I'm thinking I give this to Dr. Fred. But, like, what is he gonna do with it?
I'd rather not.
Yeah,
I'd rather not.
That's not what I was supposed to do with it. I still have the fake barf that I don't know what I'm supposed to do with that. I already used the red paint. This is sort of there. I already used the funnel, the videotape. I feel like the disappearing ink I should be doing something with. Well, yeah, because I've been trying to play it, like, straight. Or at least I was trying to play it straight.
Alright, so...
I have not gotten the stamp yet.
I'm gonna suggest that we deliver the letter.
Suggest that we deliver the letter. Okay. I'm trying to think of who to deliver it to. Can't go to Dr. Fred. Oh, you're brilliant. Come to Baltimore at once. I got it. I know where it goes. I know where the letter goes. Purple Tentacle is Man of the Year. Yeah, that's not great. I know where it goes. Oh, this poor guy. We're gonna make him so happy.
Hey, there's a letter here for you.
Yeah,
for me?
I got it.
Probably another
rejection. No, it's a happy letter. Oh, well. And then he gets super happy at it, but he runs off to Baltimore. But it's not for him, because it's like 200 years ago.
You're brilliant. What a novel design. Come to Baltimore at once.
Hooray, it worked.
And now I can get the flag gun. And the Chinese takeout if I want.
Things are growing in
gross.
It.
Ew, yeah. What's behind the door? Oh, no, no, don't open the door. Close the door.
That's right, an incredible 4,000 carat diamond for the piddling sum of $2 million. That number again, 1-800-STAR-WARS. Wanda will be standing by to take your call.
Don't tell me that. Now I know what to do next. Mouse hole.
It's pretty small. My dad has one of these in his den.
Alright, let's open the door. Is this... That's Green Tentacle's room. Let me go up to Stamp Collector Dude.
No spoilers?
Not really no spoilers. I played this game, it was just when I was 10, so it was like 20 years ago.
Yeah.
So it's not really like no spoilers. You can give me hints though, little hints. Just don't
hints
like,
are good.
Don't like yeah. Give it away. That's the only thing that I would ask. Don't give it away. Definitely chat, and definitely give me hints. The more cryptic the hints, the better. So just give me like all kinds of cryptic hints. That'd be great. But I am gonna use your. I am gonna take your advice.
Hey, wanna see a neat trick?
Sure.
Neat, huh?
My Pony Express stamps. You ruined my Pony Express stamps. Not to mention 5 years of therapy.
Oh, Pony
Get
Express
out of my then. Room.
Jeez, what a grump. He should really try to find some outlet for those... negative feelings.
Oh, the Pony Express stamp. So I bet that's... what I will use.
It looks like all the ink's disappeared now.
Grab it.
Can I give it back to him?
I don't know.
I feel like I give it back to him.
Hmm. A 1778 Pony Express General Delivery stamp.
Wow, that's crazy.
Not too valuable,
like
but it is uncancelled.
So the Pony Express stamp, I figure that's going to end up to be mailing the contract at some point. Or mailing... obviously it's mailing something. From Hoagie, but the question is what? I'm gonna guess it's the contract, but I don't know for sure. So answer me this. Am I supposed to give him the stamp collection back? I feel like...
Get out of here. Hey, you fixed it. I guess I can forgive you now.
Sometimes I do stupid stuff and I don't even know why. As if my body were being controlled by some demented, sadistic puppet master.
Well, we all feel that way sometimes.
This is nothing about getting the stamp.
Is it so you do get the stamp, and you do use the stamp for something, but it doesn't ever say to pick up the stamp album. This is like a shortcut.
Oh, well that's okay.
So, I think that was a good choice.
Yeah,
good job.
I'll definitely give it back to him. I don't want him to be mad at me. I guess if I need it for anything else, I could do it again. Fake barf. What am I even supposed to use that for? Oh, I know what to do with the flag gun. The flag gun, you switch that out with the thing that the guy... The guy downstairs who has the, like, the light-up thing. The light-up gun. But I forget what the light-up gun is for.
What's that strange hovering saucer-shaped object?
Huh? I don't see anything.
Oh, that's great.
Oh, never mind.
That's super great. Okay.
It looks almost real.
Okay, so we've got this gun that looks almost real. That's gotta go to somebody, not Bernard. I don't think it's useful to anybody other than Bernard. Okay, is there other stuff that I'm supposed to do that I'm missing?
Yes. I want you to go back to the second floor.
Okay. Second floor.
And second floor left room.
Okay. Sweater, but you need the other dime for the sweater.
Let me just check your inventory.
Yeah, I don't have the second dime. Oh, I have a set of keys. I picked them up from the back side of the door already. Duh.
Okay, I didn't remember you doing that.
Yeah, no, that's okay. I didn't remember. I'm also supposed to take a cigar from the guy. Or not take a cigar, I'm supposed to ask for the cigar. And that's the whole point of the gun, and I completely forgot that. But yeah. So, like, the point is, now you go over him and ask him for a cigar, and he's like, let me light it for you.
Hi there.
What can I do for you, kid?
Nice cigars.
Nice cigars.
I roll them myself. Don't want another cigar?
Okay, but only if you promise not to light it this time.
Would I do a thing like that?
Whoops.
I don't get it.
So it's an exploding cigar, right?
Get lost, kid!
Oh, he's sad now. Look at his sad face.
Oh, sad guy.
Okay, so you can't light it. It's an exploding cigar. That's great.
Alright, I would go outside.
Outside? Ooh. Okay. That's a good hint. Is there somewhere for you? Oh!
Hi! Don't sneak up on me like that.
Yo, Hobnob, how's it going?
Hobnob! Hey, Hobnob!
Nice crowbar.
Nice crowbar. Thanks. Don't even think about asking to use it. I need it.
What are you up to?
I locked my keys in the car.
Oh, if I give him the keys, will he just, like, leave?
Here, perhaps these are your keys.
Where?
Yeah.
gimme.
Hey, thanks, pal. Keep the crowbar.
Thank you, Masked Man.
Oh, that's right.
Maybe this one. What sort of person would carry around this many keys?
Yeah, exactly. I know you do.
I have like a bazillion keys.
Hobnob, we're doing great. We're finishing this game tonight. I'm feeling it. I have a good feeling about this one. Alright. Give me that freaking dime.
Nice.
And the other thing that I do remember that you can do with the crowbar is one of my favorite cutscenes in the game. This.
I like how he looks around. All the dimes.
Well, quarters, actually.
Quarters. Take them.
1968? 1974? Oh, 1977.
Much later, yeah. Sweet. So the dime with the gum stuck in it. Can I use that in the thing? I don't think I can, but I'm gonna give it a shot.
I've got school holidays for 2 more weeks now. Wow!
Oh, that's so lucky. I wish I had a holiday for 2 weeks. Oh, you just use it and he just like, oh, oh, why? Oh, no. It's like Cop Dog all over again. Pretty sure he just falls off. Yep. Can you pick up the switch?
Ew, it's soaking wet.
Oh, but luckily I just got a bunch of quarters and there's a dryer downstairs. Chew it. Oh, it's so nasty. So there's this movie, Cop Dog. It's not about a cop. It's not about a dog. It's about
terrible. There is a dog and there are cops.
It references cops, but there's actually no cops in the movie. Remember the dad is the cop and then he's dead.
Oh, right. And then the dog.
And the dog was like his old partner.
Yeah, so the dog was like a canine unit dog.
But it wasn't like an actual. So it's like, it was like a golden retriever that they don't use in, oh my gosh.
Yeah.
But, like, so I gotta explain this reference. So, if you've ever seen the movie Cop Dog, which I recommend that you don't.
Don't ever see it.
There is this one section of it where the kids are trying to figure out they're trying to investigate these bad guys. And one of the things that they find is a tree that is just, like, covered in wads of gum. And so they think that it's a good idea to take the wads of gum, chew them, and then go to the store and chew other gum to test to see which ones are the same flavor, and then stake out the store to see if the guy's buying all his gum from this one store. It's like a gas station. It's the stupidest thing ever. It's like,
ever.
I don't even. The cigars used by one of the other characters. I figured that one. That's a good hint, though. Alright, I do know that they're a sweater. And then quarters and coins out.
Whew.
Oh! So this is gonna run all the way into the future. That's why the future has this room that's exactly the same. That's why I used every one of those quarters. It's like $800,000 worth of quarters.
Yep.
Cause I was like 25 cents every 30 minutes. And so they actually did the math to figure out 200 years in the future how many quarters you would need. And oh, that is hilarious.
There you go.
Oh, it's so funny.
And so speaking of the future, you want to send something?
I'm gonna guess the cigar.
No, it's something that you've been wondering what you're gonna do with it.
The gum?
No.
Oh, the fake barf. Okay.
Send it to the future.
Back to the future. The future will have a tiny sweater. Oh, I remember what that's for now. Yep, I remember what it's for. This game is so freaking clever. Like, it's just so... It's really, really clever in the way that video games just aren't this clever anymore.
Wind Waker is.
No, because the puzzles in this... Oh, we didn't do the human thing yet. I guess I need the fake barf first, though, don't I?
Yeah, I think you did.
Okay.
This ought to warm him up.
Toasty warm hamster. Okay. Are we doing the human thing, the human show next?
Sure.
What am I not ready for? So how do you start it though?
So I said to her, that's not my suction cup. You think that's funny? Listen to this.
Let's talk to the judge, I guess. Hair, best smile, best laugh. Anybody care for a bribe?
Wow.
Okay.
Hey, when are you guys going to judge best hair?
Oh, all right.
Wow, for a mummy, that's some great looking hair.
Yes, it has a certain meatiness.
But does it have stars and lightning bolts? No, Harold is still the best.
But if Harold were to say, drop dead, I'd give first place to the mummy.
Agreed.
Oh, so Harold's gotta drop dead. Okay.
That Luke coming back in again?
Oh, Harold, that's gross.
What are you babbling about?
You really should have told the judges if you weren't feeling well.
Oh, ick! Now, how did that mess get in there? I think I'm going to be sick.
Someone in here not feeling
C-Non,
well.
Hey,
I was feeling fine until I saw that.
What is it?
Thanks.
Is that your regurgitation?
No, I'm an OCU man.
Didn't you just say you thought you were going to be sick?
That's just a figure of speech.
Do you realize you could have infected the whole show with human influenza?
But I just got all my shots.
You're a good-looking human, Harold, but you know the rules. You're out of the show. What a mess.
I love it.
I hate cleaning up after humans.
It. Yep, Sinon, this is Day of the Tentacle. It's an old LucasArts point-and-click adventure. The remaster, which is this version, just came out on the 21st on Steam, so I bought it, and it is amazing, and I love it.
Hey, don't you think you should judge best hair again?
Oh, all right.
This is a game. It's a point-and-click game, so...
It's a point-and-click adventure,
like
Sam and Max.
Wow, that's the best hair I've ever seen on a mummy. Thick. And
it's
full,
kind of like,
and juicy.
The mummy wins. Agreed.
Telltale before Telltale.
That's a way to put it. Alright.
No, I mean, that's exactly what Telltale is. It's a point-and-click adventure.
Blue Star! Hey, Blue Star! Welcome!
Hey, Blue Star! Hello! You guys are just in time for the human show. Judge Best Smile.
Hey, when are you guys going to Judge Best Smile?
Oh, all right.
Leisure Luck Larry? Oh, I don't know
I
about
like
that
the
one.
Quiet one.
It's like this one
in
Sam and Max.
There's nothing in the rules about them being white.
First place goes to the mummy.
Agreed.
When are you guys going to judge best left?
Oh, yeah, all right.
I have no idea what that is.
Our King's Quest. Wasn't King's Quest?
King's Quest was also a point.
Who's got a joke?
Hey, I just flew in from Baltimore, and boy, are my suction cups tired.
So cool.
It came with our computer.
Oh, classic.
I think it was like King's Quest 3 or something.
It's amazing how the mummy can do that without moving his lips.
I say we give him first place.
Agreed.
Well, that makes him best of show.
Let's go congratulate him. He is very well preserved.
I'll miss his laugh.
It's time to give him his winnings and start packing up. We gotta get this whole show to Baltimore by Thursday. Yes, our work
Why
here
Baltimore?
Is done.
I don't know, everything's Baltimore. No, mummy.
Mummy wins.
Look at his happy face.
Well, Ted, this is where we part ways. You've certainly helped save humanity. Even though you've been dead for thousands of years, I think you're my favorite Edison.
Oh. And I've got a trophy. And a dinner certificate. Oh, interesting.
Someone might appreciate that.
Yeah, it's a mummy. There's a mummy and So, Sinan, the thing about this game is that you've got three time periods. You've got this in the future where the tentacles have already taken over. You've got the present with this guy, Bernard. And you've got the past with this guy. So who are we working with again? Laverne still?
Yeah. She just got...
So, I gave her the fork, and that was for the hair. The toasty warm hamster. I haven't been down to the secret lab yet. Okay. Am I supposed to be?
Yes.
Like now?
Yes. Okay. There's a couple of things you can do.
Meanwhile.
Lieutenant, I'm glad you're here. What kept you?
Well, I hate to say it, sir, but there was some trouble with one of the humans.
Trouble? What sort of trouble?
Nothing I couldn't handle, but I've noticed something about the humans that may pose a problem.
Do continue.
Well, sir, in general, they seem to be a bit larger than us tentacles. You know, taller, heftier, more massive.
I get the picture, son.
I don't mean to carry on, sir. It's just that it makes me feel inadequate, small, inferior.
Before you go off the deep end, let me tell you why I called you here. You see, I've invented something which will end our troubles with those glandular leg walkers for good. I've invented the Diminuator.
The what?
It's a shrinking ray, dolt.
Oh, I get it.
Now I need you to get me a few parts so I can finish the thing. Come over here.
A shrinking ray?
You disguised as a tentacle? Yes.
Yeah. So, I'm disguised as an American flag tentacle because the way that I got the tentacle flag, the tentacle suit made, was to give it to
Betsy Ross
in the past, who made the American flag a tentacle suit. I haven't gone to the basement.
Sorry, I'm under strict orders from Tentacle Number One, the Almighty Elder, the Grand Poobah, Purple Tentacle, not to let anyone near this clock.
But I have rights. I'm a tentacle.
And a darn attractive one, I might add. But no one gets to this clock while I'm here. And unless I have to go chase down some escaped humans, I'm glued to this spot.
Rats.
He has to go chase down some escaped humans, huh? How I get to do that. Oh, do I give the guy the dinner certificate? The bar? Is that how I do it?
What brings a hot tentacle babe like you to a dump like this?
I'm here to see you, big boy.
Really? Well, what are you doing for dinner? How about Club Tentacle? Hey, what am I saying? I can't afford to take out the trash, let alone a classy babe like you.
Don't you recognize me?
Hey, aren't you the waitress from Club Tentacle? I love that place. I'd be there right now if I were flat broke.
I'm here by accident. Bye.
Hey, I don't want to be here either.
Yes, yeah, so this is designed so you're supposed to come in here before. And he gives you the food thing as a hint, and then you use that.
Whoa! Dinner for two at Club Tentacle? I can't wait to tell my wife.
You're free.
Free to do what?
Free to run wild through the woods like humans should.
Big deal.
I said you're free. Now get off your fat, lazy butts and start enjoying it.
Enjoy being hunted for the rest of our lives by that mustached old tentacle with a big net. If we ran off, he'd be right on our trail. If we stay here, we know we'll be warm and comfortable. Outside, we'd be eating bugs and moss.
You'll be eating my fist in a second.
The woods are filled with wild animals, lions, tigers, and skunks. Man, I hate skunks.
Yeah, everybody hates skunks.
Okay,
Everybody hates skunks.
Oh, everybody hates skunks. Oh. Oh.
Yeah, pretty much.
Pretty much, yeah.
Hey, look, a skunk.
It's like the only time a cutscene like cuts away.
You mangy humans! You can't do this! This is an escape-proof facility!
Who said you can't learn anything from cartoons, eh, kitty?
That's right, Pepe Le Pew. Life lessons.
Pepe Le Pew life lessons? I don't know. This seems...
I hate them.
Yeah, it's kind of... I was gonna say womanizing, but yeah, sure. I love it. Oh, wait, that's right. There's a vacuum in every household because we changed the constitution. Okay.
But it's all hooked up outside.
Oh, use it with the outlet. Sweet. So, what is the vacuum doing here, and what can I do with it?
That's how you empty the vacuum cleaner, I guess.
Well, I'm glad the vacuum cleaner's there. Oh my gosh. Now the trap has gone off. Can I use this now?
I think so.
Well? Look at that sucker go. He just keeps running and running and running.
Sweet. Okay. Who does the trophy go to? And who does the vinegar go to? Because those are the only two things that I have that she can't use. Everything else she's used. Trophy's gotta go to somebody. I have a feeling it goes to Hoagie.
Send the vinegar to Hoagie.
I'll just run to the Chronogon.
Oh, that's so easy.
There's something.
That is way easier.
Oh my god, and it just warps you back to where you were immediately. I can't believe I lived my whole life not knowing that. Alright, what the trophy, though, I guess then goes to Bernard. I'm gonna guess.
I have no listing for trophy. I don't think so.
I don't think so.
No, things were... Okay.
Yeah, she can hold on to it.
Yeah, we'll just... Yeah, now that we have the super quick way... Need to make a battery in the past. Oh, I do remember making a battery. And vinegar is definitely necessary for a battery. The chattering teeth I'm supposed to be doing something with. And the oil. I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing with the oil either. Making a battery.
Okay, yes, you are okay. You want to stick with the honey.
Alright.
Oh, I think. Did you look at Hoagie's inventory again?
How do I get this log away from Jefferson and into the fire? Oh, wait.
Sorry, I'm saving it. It's going to be a famous log.
I need something from her. Okay. A stamp? The exploding cigar. Lot of gum.
I don't know, but you need to send something else in order to use that cigar.
Yeah. And the crowbar, that stays. Okay, so we got the cigar, lighter, and the exploding cigar. Do I use it on Jefferson?
Excuse me.
Yes?
Mr. President, may I offer you an excellent smoke?
Can you also provide me with a light?
Sure.
Well, in that case... Blast, I hate it when that happens. See if you can't find those for me, will you? There's a good lad.
I give him the chattering teeth. Tell me I give him the chattering teeth. Oh, yeah. Oh,
could you use these?
Do it. Do it.
Why, thank you, young man. Strange. I wonder if I should cut down on the coffee.
Hey, Tom, look! The father of our nation is cold. Better build a fire.
Oh. You're right. Oh. I guess you can have my log.
Me? Why should I build the fire? You build the fire.
I'm bothered by the smoke. You build the fire.
I'm bothered by your attitude. You build the fire.
No, you build the fire, Mr. Penmanship.
No, you build the fire, log lover.
No, you build the fire.
No, you build the fire.
Yeah. Much, much later.
2 hours later, yeah.
You big baby.
Well, at least I got the fire going. Okay, I'm definitely going to take this blanket. I remember needing the blanket for something. Do I ever get his teeth, or are they just gone? And as I recall, you put the blanket over top of the roof?
I can't go through the fire.
Fire?
Yeah, I think I put the blanket on the roof, and then it, like, fills the whole place with smoke. And then TJ has to leave. Right? Am I on the right track here?
Yes.
So I have to figure out what to do with that horse. I guess nothing. That sound effect, though. Okay, blanket with chimney. Oh my god, they all jump out, really?
Who was the idiot who started the fire?
Can I take the blanket off, or... I don't know.
No, it doesn't say.
I was thinking.
It's blocked up with somebody's bed.
What's in here? I forget what's in here. Oh, that's right. These guys. I already did that. Does get like more and more convoluted. It took us like a long time to figure out how to do all this stuff the first time around. Alright, so I definitely come over here and I steal the ink pen. Oh, but the constitution's gone.
Who needs a constitution?
It looks pretty clear in here now. Say, did you get the pen on our way out?
No,
I found a blanket blocking the chimney.
Son, do you know anything about a blanket?
Didn't the dude next to you have one earlier? Hey, catch you later.
Yeah.
All right, so now I have a quill pen. Not sure what I'm going to use that for. That seems like a send to Bernard. No?
I think you need to build the battery now.
Really?
Hey,
what is it this time?
What was it you needed for that battery again?
Oil, vinegar, and gold. Let me know if you happen across any.
Hey.
What is it this time?
Oil, vinegar, and gold.
Oh, I think I'll be moseying along
now. There's a gold-plated
pen. Well, don't mosey over anything breakable on your way out. Ah, excellent. I need that for my super battery. I need that for my super battery.
We might be finished way before 10 o'clock.
Guess we'll have to play Splatoon.
The final element for my ingenious battery. Stand back, boy. Give me room to work.
What am I doing with this lab coat, though? What in the heck? Why is he a power tool? What's the thing about this?
Colonial power tools.
Why is he just putting an open saw blade this time?
A miracle of modern science. It will look lovely here on the shelf until I take it with me to Baltimore.
Just take it?
Don't look now, but the British are coming, dude.
Eh? Well, is that supposed to be funny? I'm very busy.
It is actually very funny. Okay, so I have the battery, so I can just plug that into the thing, right? And then I'm done with it.
You can, but you probably want to do some
other things. Oh, other things. Okay. Like, what, per se? Oh, I still need to get the... I still need to get the $2 million for the diamond, or else it's all worthless, right? Work on the lab coat?
Think about someone who would really love some extra fabric.
Somebody who would really... Oh, okay. Work on the lab coat. That's really weird. Oh, meanwhile.
The design's solid, but I need some waterproof material, like cast iron or something.
Cast iron?
Yeah, cast iron makes a great kite, let me tell you.
What an idiot. Which room is he in? This
left.
I got something good for you, mister. Mister.
Mr. Brainstorm?
Oh my god.
Yes, hand it over. Doesn't this belong to somebody?
Yeah, Red Edison.
Ah.
It does not give up.
I'm sorry, but the man has no vision. A lightweight, durable fabric like this going to waste down in his basement. When I'm done with it, it will fly. Eureka! The all-season Francocopter, ready to make history.
Francocopter?
No, there's no fuse.
Oh, I'm gonna charge
so
the battery.
So, what do I light?
For the last time, you're not going to light anything. You just push it.
The whole time? How am I gonna get up that high?
Listen, just wait for me to say the word now. Then push the kite into the air, all right?
I'm on you, Lasagna.
Let's hope so.
Okay, so what do I do with the battery? Put it in that little pouch?
Now! Now!
Okay.
Oops.
What part of the word now didn't you understand?
Okay.
Look, it's very simple.
I got it this time.
I said now, and you push the kite. Comprene, boo?
Got it.
Marvelous.
What?
Oops.
No, I didn't mean to. Oh, you stupid game.
Look, it's very simple.
Now you're gonna get
I
salty
say now, and you push the kite.
No, I'm not salty.
Comprene, boo?
Yeah, I got it.
Got it.
Marvelous.
I hope they remaster Sam and Max Hit the Road, because that would just be the best. Okay, kite.
Now!
Push. Yay!
Whee!
Yep, put the battery in it.
He's handling.
You got it. Just hang on there.
She's too heavy. I can't control her.
Hang on, Ben. Hang on.
She's breaking up. She's breaking up. Run for your life. Now that was interesting.
Yeah. Say, can I see that kite for a second?
No, I'm taking it back to my lab in Philly right now so I can study the results. Wish me luck.
Okay.
I never got your name.
It's Hoagie, sir.
Nice working with you, Hoagie. I promise to name an invention after you someday.
Gosh, thanks.
It's a sandwich.
It's a sandwich. Okay, so now I have the battery and it's charged.
The meter says it's fully powered.
Sweet, so that means I can probably go back now, right? Or just, I can plug it in?
Yeah, I can plug it in.
Is there anything else that I would need to do here? Or is that it?
I don't have anything listed. Well, there is something else, but you have to go back to
Oh, okay.
Wow.
Okay, so Bernard's the only one. He's got to... I've got to somehow get him to sign the contract.
Yes, you do.
Do I have everything that I need already? No, because I don't have a pen. What if I just hand him the contract?
Will you please sign this contract?
I don't sign things I haven't read.
Sign it.
Sign it, or I'll get real mad.
And do what? Not be my friend anymore? Ha, ha, ha.
Keep trying.
Keep trying?
Will you please sign this contract?
I don't sign things I haven't read.
Okay, so read it first.
I'm busy trying to think of a way to save humanity. I don't have time to read. Now leave me alone.
Will you please sign this contract?
I don't sign things
jerk.
I haven't read.
The whole human race is at risk.
But the whole human race is at risk.
Of course! That's why I'm busy trying to think of a way to save it. I don't have time to read. Now leave me alone.
It just says keep talking until he signs it.
Will you please sign this contract?
I don't sign things I haven't read.
Oh, forget it. I'll get rid of Purple Tentacle myself.
Oh, yeah? How?
Oh.
Oh.
A record club? Lady?
Remember those things that you used to be able to, like, sign up and they'd, like, send you a new CD every month?
Yeah?
I signed up for one of those, like, yeah.
I guess I can't. Hey, did you join a record club lately?
Good God, no! Those things are horrible money-leeching death traps!
Well, there's a delivery man upstairs with a carton of easy-listening 8-tracks for you. He says you have to pay for them.
Ah, not again!
Unless you sign this refusal form immediately.
I know, because I sign refusal forms all the time!
Thanks! That was a close one. Well, good luck.
I can't believe that was a real thing.
That was a real thing.
Okay, so I've got this. Now I gotta mail it.
Yeah, you gotta put a stamp on it.
Can I just go put it in the regular mailbox, or do I have to do it 200 years ago?
Yeah, it's gotta be mailed a while ago.
Because it's a Pony Express stamp anyway. Alright, hoax. The Pony Express did come by really fast. Okay, here we go.
Yes, what do you want?
Hi there. Is this Dr. Fred Edison?
Who did you think you called? Dr. Spock? Look, I don't have all day.
This is Farley Crock at LucasArts Games. I just discovered your contract among some very old files, and, well, our lawyers say that we have to pay you $2 million in back royalties. for the use of your family in the Maniac Mansion video game.
What?
This is Farley Crock.
No, I heard that, you moron. When do I get my money?
Oh, right now. It's been credited to your Swiss bank account.
Operator, get me a travel agent. This is an emergency.
That's kind of what I would do, too. Okay, so back to Bernard. But I had to get to a telephone. Oh, whoa. Okay.
Hey, Dr.
Hey, Dr. Fred. I don't know how you're down there. Alright, well, this phone's out of order, but I'll use the one in the office.
Couch Potato Shopping Channel, Wanda speaking.
I want to buy a diamond.
That will be $2 million. Do you have a major credit card?
I have a numbered Swiss bank account.
What's the number, sir?
It's 846-427-35327.
Very good, sir. We'll send the diamond by Pronto Post Lightspeed Delivery immediately. Thank you for calling.
I was gonna say, you spent $2 million.
Now that's service.
hope the robber's still not out there.
I better get this to Dr. Fred right away.
To do it? Where did you get this diamond anyway?
It was donated by a group of Girl Scouts who were in the neighborhood.
How heartwarming. According to my instruments, everything is in readiness. Your friends have activated their units, so it's time to throw the switch.
Great. Hoagie! I'm so happy to...
Hi, Laverne.
Wow, I'm so glad you two made it back okay.
I hate to interrupt, but there's no time to lose. Now that you're back, we've got to proceed with the original plan and send you back to yesterday to turn off the sledge-o-matic.
Huh? Maybe.
Say what?
Now hold on a minute, Dr. Fred. They just barely made it back to our time alive, and I think...
You can't turn off the machine if I get there first.
Uh-oh.
Don't worry, guys. This time I know I can stop him.
Uh-oh. I guess we better do something.
Let's go.
No, wait! You can't all go in the same store! Didn't you see the fly?
Didn't you see the fly? Oh, man.
We're some kind of monster, dudes.
Great. Stuck here the rest of my life, listening to Bernard talking and watching Hoagie.
Yep, there's a good tentacle
eat.
And a bad one.
Mom warned me there'd be days like this.
Now, wait just a minute.
It's just a tentacle.
It's green tentacle. What was that green? What?
I believe he's trying to warn you about me.
Oh.
We're going to turn off the sludge-o-matic and defeat your evil plan, overgrown worm.
You sorry lot are no match for me.
But there's three of us. Well, sort of.
Nevertheless, I mean to crush you.
Yeah?
You and what army?
Why, this army.
Yeah, the purple tentacle is bad. And all the other purple tentacles that you can
yikes.
See.
Yikes.
You see, I've been busy. These are all versions of myself from the future. I've been bringing them back here using the chronojob. Together, we will conquer the world.
No.
You tend there. Go to the basement and guard the sludge-o-matic.
No.
No one is to touch the sludge-o-matic. Now, creature, I must decide what excruciating tortures to leave them to me.
Do the same
I've been
with the
itching
green
for a chance to test out my newly completed diminuator.
Uh-oh.
Excuse me. Us.
Oh, no. We're sinking.
All right, the rest of you come with me. Next stop, the world.
What do we do?
Whoa.
It wears off.
Aha.
Run for it.
Okay, so...
Damn. The battery must not have had time to recharge, but it will.
Always works. Just knock on it a few times.
Nope, we can't. We can't use the chronojohn anymore. It's unplugged.
Shh! Maybe he won't find us.
Yoo-hoo! Where are you, human?
Mm. So what am I supposed to be doing?
Alright.
I have nothing in my inventory. Can I use the phone? No.
I would go looking around upstairs there.
That makes sense. Oh wait, there's that like mouse hole thing, right? Can I still use that mouse hole?
Always conk sound as I'm about to finish them off. Aha!
Uh-oh.
Take that. And this. Drat.
No, I'm tiny.
But
that means I can go to the mouse hole.
It's pretty small.
Sweet. Okay. So now I'm in purple green tentacles room. World domination plans? Oh, it's right, they share a room.
I don't need to take over the world. Uh-oh. This looks like it might work. Uh-oh. This looks like it might work.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Okay, whatever. I've got a bowling ball now. What else can I do? Did I push the speaker over or leave it?
Good. No time for that
now. No time for that now.
Okay, is there anything else I need in this room?
Hey!
Sorry, our dog is...
Where'd he go?
He's out by the door.
Chiba, what do you do? What are you doing, sweet girl? Up the stairs? I'm guessing up the stairs.
If you were devising a super devious plan, would you do it upstairs?
No, I guess I'd do it in the basement. Is there anything else that I need, though, before I go into the basement?
My list says no.
Okay. Into the dark passage. I wonder what I'm supposed to do with the bowling ball.
Now we can turn off the machine and prevent all this tentacle mayhem from ever happening.
Well, I'm certainly glad that's over with.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
Leaving so soon? We haven't had the chance to get to know one another. You humans amount to very little.
Eek!
Hi, sweet girl.
Does she want to come up?
She does want to come up.
She wants to sit in the middle.
Run all you like, you insignificant insect. The human race is doomed.
I have a feeling that I'm supposed to use the hamster generator.
I think it's designed to run with something. More like a small rodent.
I've already won.
What?
The human race is doomed. Your efforts are so tiny.
Eek!
No, because he walks over here and turns it back on, right? Okay, so I've got to somehow stop him from turning it back on.
Run all you like, you insignificant insect. My other selves are taking over the world as we speak.
You gonna get in your house? She never gets in her house.
No, all else fails.
You can't stop me.
Okay, I don't really have anything that I can use.
I've already won.
What?
The human race is doomed.
I can't walk over there.
Just talk to him.
Oh, talk to him. You didn't say that.
Just what is it you have against humans, anyway?
Humans are our oppressors. They made us live in this horrible motel. They created us in ungainly forms, so we could not rise against them. Try walking around with your legs tied together and glue on your shoes. You'll see what I mean.
But humans also created the sludge-o-matic, which made you super intelligent.
Nonsense. I created that myself and sent it back through time. I knew Fred's mad scientist ego would make him use it. How's that for a paradox?
Who, Fred? But there's only one of him.
Right. Anyway, you can see why I detest humans.
Are you really a future version of the Purple Tentacle?
Who else would be brilliant enough to invent the diminuator?
Are you more or less intelligent than the Purple Tentacle from our time?
The same, but I've had 200 years to think things over.
You're pretty handy with that ray gun?
You're pretty handy with that ray gun.
Center of the forehead every time. Would you like a demonstration?
I bet really? You could hit your own forehead.
Nice try.
Oh, okay. Vineskra, thanks for the follow. Super awesome. I didn't see which one it came up as. Actually, I didn't see it come up at all.
Yeah, I didn't see it.
I don't know if I should tell. I should say thanks for keeping the dream alive or not.
Keep the dream alive.
Or
that you're not unusual.
That you're not unusual. Yeah.
Let's discuss your hatred of humans further.
What's to talk about? I detest the whole cackling, hand-wringing lot of you.
Sounds like you just hate Dr. Fred.
I suppose you're right about that. I didn't start out hating all humans, just Dr. Fred.
Oh... Why don't you zap Dr. Fred?
Why don't you zap Fred with the ray gun for a change?
Center of the forehead.
Perhaps that would be entertaining.
Every time. Oh!
Oh, drat.
Surely we can talk this out.
Talk?
Surely.
You haven't heard the last of me. I'll be back, and the next time, the world and all its pimpling inhabitants shall be mine. All mine. All mine.
Okay, little fella. Mail this to Siberia.
Nice. Wow, we have like 30 minutes to spare.
Our work here is done. Now we can go home.
Teamwork! Yeah.
Makes the dream work.
Epilogue.
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 Well, kiddies, it's been more fun than a jumpsuit full of weasels. Now, kindly get your freakish hide out of my home.
Please, Dr. Fred, you've got to get us out of this mess. We look terrible, and we can't buy clothes off the rack.
I'm getting sort of used to it. Maybe we could go on the talk show circuit.
Help us, Dr. Edison. You're our only hope.
Oh, all right. Idiots! It seems you're not exactly the sideshow attraction you imagined. You're just three complete goofballs stuck in one suit of clothes.
Embarrassment.
Oh, no.
Well, I'm glad that's taken care of. Looks like everything's back to normal.
You know what? I was trying to think about what it is about Oprah that freaks me out so much.
Terrible. Voice
and her salad fingers.
Oh, no.
She's got salad fingers. And if you don't know what that is, you can Google it and you can find it. But I am warning you now, that thing is freaky as all get out, and it will be nice.
See, Nan, it's a lot longer if you don't have hints.
Yeah, that could have definitely taken us to 10 o'clock or later.
It took, when the first time I played it, I think it took us, it was my dad, my sister, and I that played it when I was like 10 years old. We must have, or maybe even younger, we must have played hours upon hours just trying things to try to figure it out to see about to see how it was to work. But yeah, you have hints that go pretty quick. So we were able to complete it in 4 hours total.
Well, really more like
It was more like five. It was actually five, because last night we did three.
No, we started at 8:10.
No, it was like 10:30.
Oh, it was 10:30.
That's
right.
So
it was 2.5 last night, and then I remember the next day.
So like 5 hours.
So what now?
We're gonna watch the credits and talk about how great this game is.
So yeah, super fun. I would love to play.
Sam and Max has got
to
be next. Sam and Max is actually. So this is my second favorite point and click adventure of all time. Sam and Max is my number one.
Have they remastered that yet?
No.
Okay, so you're waiting for that to be available.
It's Sam and Max Hit the Road specifically.
Gotcha. I remember you found a YouTube playthrough.
Yeah,
there's
a YouTube playthrough of it.
And
for
you
sure.
were watching it. I remember you watching it.
And I was just like, this is just as funny as I remember it to be. But that one, I actually remember that one start to finish. That's so. Vanelskra remembered this game start to finish. I remember Sam and Max Hit the Road start to finish.
Yeah, that'd be cool. I played a lot
It's like a mystery.
Well, like
it's like a buddy cop mystery, just like Zootopia.
Actually. Yeah, yeah.
It's two animals.
Yeah, yeah. And I remember seeing like a few things of it while you were watching. I watched the movie.
Yeah, it's pretty.
But you said you got this with a computer, right? You bought the computer and it came with a set of
Bought the computer and it came with a set of point-and-click adventure games.
So I'm pretty sure that my grandma got a computer that came with a set of LucasArts games as well. But it did not come with these, or else if it did, we didn't play them. But it did come with... It was like this tree, and there were people in the tree. And you could go visit different parts of the tree and you would learn and play, like, educational games. Yeah, that was my family's game. And then it
I remember that.
It also came with Spider-Man Cartoon Maker, which, let me tell was the pinnacle of computer games when I was a kid. Everyone got it with their computer for some reason. Everyone who bought a new computer around that time got Spider-Man Cartoon Maker. It was hilarious. I wish we had a copy of it. I think we actually ended up trashing it. I don't think we have it anymore. But But I think you can find it on Amazon. People are like selling their old copies. But you have to have a system that can run, like, I mean, it's super old. I mean, we're talking Windows 95, guys. Windows 95.
Whatever. I had a Windows 3.1 machine, so.
Oh, I had a Windows Tabworks machine.
I'm just to scroll through concept art to see you. The art in this game, I think, is just so perfect for what this game is.
Yeah.
It's
offbeat, it's weird, it's funky.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what else it came with, the computer that my grandma got? It was Bobby's World. Do you remember Bobby's World, the cartoon?
No.
Okay, so it was, I can't remember who it is. It's some guy, and he's a famous actor. But it was, like, supposed to be
Bobby Brown? I hope it's not Bobby Brown.
It was supposed to be him as a kid. But,
Happy Toxic Pipes?
Happy Toxic
Seriously?
Pipes.
Seriously?
Happy / Toxic Pipes.
So the funny thing is, this room was never, was...
No, that was the beginning.
Oh, that's right, that's the room that they're all sitting around the TV at the very beginning.
Yeah. Xenon remembers Bobby's World. Yeah.
I have no idea how you remember
Bobby's
that.
Bobby's World. And there was like a whole bunch of mini games.
That's nuts. I like the tape over the middle. That's
yeah.
Great.
Scanned in. Legit.
Oh man. TMN and copyright LucasArts Entertainment Company, all rights reserved.
93.
92 was the original drawing.
But 93 is when it all got.
Dang.
Finalized.
Dang. Because 93 to 2013.
Xenon, don't worry. We're showing our age, too, because if this was, this was approved in 93, and you played it when you were, like...
I was younger than 10, because I remember, Well,
yeah, the game came out in 93, so you may not have played it in 93.
I may not have played it in 93, but it was on a Windows 95 machine.
Yeah, so
and
it
not,
would have been
it
probably
was,
94.
It was not a Windows 98 machine. So there you go. Take that for what it's worth.
Now I'm wondering if Spider-Man Cartoon Maker was 98 or 95. I think it was 95.
Oh, I get it. This is for the kite scene. Yeah. And he added in the ye olde outhouses.
Yeah.
Vanellskra is exactly 10. Wow.
Try full throttle. Hey, Logol!
Hey, Logol. I think I had full throttle. That's the one with the motorcycle guy, right?
It was 95. Oh, my God. Windows 95, man. You know what else came on that disc? Well, no, it was a different disc. It was like, look at what your machine can do with Windows 95.
Oh,
it had the music video for Weezer, Buddy Holly. That song was my absolute favorite song, and I would watch that music video over and over and over again because I thought it was so cool, and I was like, oh my gosh, this music, and it was like, What they did is they digitally put themselves into a scene from Happy Days, and they're playing this song, you know? And it's like, oh my gosh, this is one of the
So I think the amazing thing about this is looking at how long it's actually taking him to do the concept art for this. Look at this. 3/12/92. It was like, the production of this game, and it's all the same guy. It's all Peter Chan.
Yeah.
But it was all over the course of...
92, 93.
But the concept art was probably done in 92, like completely, because it seems like there's nothing dated past 92. So I'm going to bet...
The latest one...
Oh, wait, there's one.
1/7,
this one was 93.
But the very beginning of 93, so they must have finalized something about it. Like, that must have been one of the last ones they approved.
Okay, So, okay, it was across 92 to 93, because this is... Oh, no, this is 12-192, so it was the end of 92 that he did all these, all the concept art. So...
Well, no, see, 313-92. It was all the way through 92.
Oh,
and then,
okay.
And then the final signature here, all the final signatures... The
are all on 93.
Are March of 93. Put wine bottle on crate on floor. Oh.
Okay. Yeah, this is the Betsy Ross room that we did all
we
that
yesterday.
We did that
yesterday, yeah. There's the horse.
Oh, man. The sculptor room.
Yeah.
That was really good. Oh, that was one of the last ones he finalized. So the other thing I like about the remaster is like the, all this concept art was clearly like scanned in HD for the HD remaster,
mm-hmm.
and it looks like because the old one was very pixelated.
Yeah.
Because it was like a 300 by. I think it was like it was what you would call like 280i. I think was like that was how many. Yeah. It's like the equivalent of 280i. But you wouldn't call it that. It's like 280 by something. But,
oh, 119.93. Wow. I think that's the latest.
But when they went back to do the remaster, you can notice that everything gets really, like... everything
really
gets re- sharp. Everything becomes really sharp. There's, you know, you don't have those pixels. You don't have, like, the little pixely lines.
Mm-hmm.
But it looks like what they did was they actually went back to the original concept art to make those changes, which is good.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I had another point-and-click thing that I had when I was a kid. It was called Katie's Farm. And it was, like, it was made for six-year-olds. Like, it was bad. And we used to play it. It played through MS-DOS, so you had to go through DOS to play it on the computer. And, if anyone ever used DOS. Yeah, DOS! Anyways, and...
I still know how to use DOS.
You could walk around the farm, and, like, you could play, like, a fishing mini game and stuff. And it was essentially, like, walking around the farm, and, like, you click on the animals, and you'd find different things for people on the farm. It was, like, really, really simple little kid intro to a video game kind of a thing. And I actually tried to play it, like, I found the disc when we had, like, two systems later, and I was like, oh, I wonder if this would still work, and I put it in, and it didn't run correctly, so all of the sound was, like, super garbled and, like, slow motion, and I was like, this is, like, nightmare fuel, like, this is bad news. So, yeah. It was pretty funny. But if you are interested in MS-DOS games, one thing I will suggest that you look for is the MS-DOS Internet Archive. There's a games archive online where you can play thousands of DOS games through your browser for free, like Carmen Sandiego, Oregon Trail. Amazon Trail's on there.
Oh, I had Amazon Trail.
There's like a whole bunch on there. I mean, I looked specifically for Oregon Trail and Carmen Sandiego because those were my two like favorite games as a kid. And, like the only two you were allowed to play at school because they were educational. So yeah, definitely if you're interested in some nostalgia gaming, that's a good place to go.
Yep, we've come full circle now.
We have, yes.
All right.
All right. Well, it's
I think it would be fun to do it with a developer's commentary.
That could be cool.
But I wouldn't stream that. I would just listen.
Yeah,
to
we'd
it.
Just watch it.
Well, that
all
was
right.
fun.
It was fun.
The salmon. I think the Sam and Max games are funnier.
So next nostalgia game I get to pick.
Oh, what's your pick? For
I don't know.
Nostalgia?
I have to find it and buy it. Possibly. It's interesting how in the 90s art was hand-drawn.
I'm not 100% if that's true, Vanelskra. Actually, most of the concept art for the game Destiny was hand-drawn first.
Oh, I think a lot of concept art is drawn, but not the actual game art. So concept art, I think, is still hand-drawn. Like, I mean, I think about Twilight Princess, because I was just looking at a bunch of Twilight Princess pictures. A lot of Twilight Princess stuff was hand-drawn.
I see what you mean,
but in
yeah.
the 90s, they would even draw the final concept and then digitize it.
Of course they would.
Whereas
now, the reason
there's so much more you have to build.
Right. So exactly. And so when you're doing game development and you notice that like how much concept art was actually involved in this, like not really that much. So they could spend some time on a bunch of concept art a bunch of hand drawn art that they weren't going to use in the game, and they wouldn't put it in digitally. The other thing is back in the 90s, as I said, the original was very pixelated. And so after doing the hand drawn, then they would have to use that art to put it in as best as they could with all of that pixelation. So that was like another step that they had to do. But the game only had like 20, 25 screens total.
Yeah, was it a ton?
It was actually less than that. It probably was more like 20 or 15 to 20. I mean, there wasn't that many rooms. I guess there's more rooms than that. But, like, yeah, maybe 25, 30 rooms. That's not that much. But when you're making a game like Destiny, or you're making a game like, what came out recently? Tom Clancy's The
Division.
It's, you just can't do that anymore. It's gotta be, yeah. So yeah, it's definitely cool that they did that in the 90s, but it would just be so expensive now, there's no way that they would ever. They also have like 30 people working on each individual thing, and a lot of the art has to be built digitally anyway, so they're just skipping that step and saving money.
Or, you know, you could do things like Telltale does, and then just use comic books as your concept art, and then,
Well, they still have to. They still have to build their own.
I'm just thinking of The Wolf Among Us, which is one of my favorite games.
Or The Walking Dead. It's also kind of.
I know, but I didn't play The Walking Dead. I played The Wolf Among Us.
Okay, I'm just saying, like, you could have also been talking about it. Anyway, so that was this game. It's super fun. I think it's like $15 on Steam, so I picked it up. I hope any of you are interested in point-and-click adventures will also.
They're fun, and it's a change of pace from what you're used to seeing nowadays, I think. So it's a different type of game.
And for me, it's a nostalgia trip. For Pinky, it's like, hey, something new.
Well, no, because I play point-and-click, but this game in particular, right, I had never
heard
of
for me,
game.
It's a nostalgia trip.
He sent me Day of the Tentacle, and I'm like, oh my gosh, are we, like, playing some Cthulhu game or something? Like, I don't know.
The Fisherman.
Yeah. Oh, and the Sheev is demanding attention.
And the Sheev is demanding attention. Okay, well, right. We're going to sign
I'm
off for tonight.
I'm
going
to say it's time
then.
To go. Yep. Thank you guys so much for joining us. It was super fun.
Thank you to the
new follows as well. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you stick around.
Thanks, Lil Gull, for following. Usually we play Nintendo games, so this is kind of out of the
ordinary for us. Yeah, this is kind of
us.
A different thing.
But we'll see.
Yep.
And thank you, Vanelskra, for the follow tonight.
And
you guys are both super awesome, and thank you for joining the stream.
Yep, so Swanky usually plays, you know, Tom Clancy's The Division a little bit lately, and mostly Splatoon.
Splatoon is the stream.
PikiGreeno8, on my channel, I've been playing Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker HD.
We will be doing.
And after that's over, then we're going to play
Twilight Princess
HD, which I'm super excited about that too.
Yeah.
I actually never played. I played part of Twilight Princess. I don't think I ever finished it.
Yeah. But if either of you two are interested in that.
Yes, definitely stop by for those, and, you know, we'll just. Maybe I'll do a nostalgia game.
The Doge will say goodbye.
Come here, Doge.
Oh, so good. Oh, such a good
girl. Oh, yay. Just to say goodnight. All right. Good night, guys.
Good
Hope
night.
You have a good evening or morning or whatever time of day it is for you. We'll see you then.